Hello. This is a drawing of my daughter, Stephanie Situ. Stephanie and I wish all of you had a wonderful Mother's Day weekend. I will be discussing minimizing breast surgery. I do have some relevant disclosures. I receive research grants from Novian Health, who sponsors our laser ablation studies, Ice Cure Medical, who sponsors our cryotherapy ablation studies, and Theracleon for high-intensity focused ultrasound. I will go over thermoablation, laser, cryoablation, and high-intensity focused ultrasound. Surgery is the oldest oncologic discipline, dating back thousands of years, and surgery remains the most effective single modality of treatment to treat cancer. And over the years, cancer surgery has flourished, driven relentlessly by technical innovations and research. In breast cancer surgery, as Dr. Tabak said, we've moved away from radical mastectomy, where we excise the entire breast, chest wall, and all the axillary lymph nodes, to now performing lumpectomy, or excision of the breast tumor with a rim of normal breast tissue, preserving the breast. And similarly in the axilla, we've moved away from axillary lymph node dissection, where we excised level 1 and some level 2 lymph nodes, to now removing only 2 to 3 average sentinel lymph nodes, but reducing the complication such as lymphedema or chronic swelling of the arm. Following this trend of minimizing the extent of cancer surgery without compromising the outcome, but increasing the preservation of form, function, and quality of life for patients, the next logical step or question is, can we now treat the primary tumor in the breast without surgery? And yes, we can. It is becoming increasingly possible and desirable to treat tumors of the breast without surgery. And we do this by using thermoablation. So thermoablation applies extreme temperatures, either heat or cold, locally and directly to the breast tumor, thereby inducing irreversible cell injury, tumor apoptosis, and as well as coagulative necrosis, or tumor death. Heat modalities include radiofrequency ablation, microwave, and some newer techniques such as laser and high-intensity focused ultrasound. Cryoablation uses cold to treat tumors. The advantages of thermoablation include, it is a procedure that's done in the office. I ablate and treat the tumor of the breast for the patient in my office. The woman gets up, walks out of the clinic, and goes home, and recovers in 1 to 2 days. The procedure is done more precisely. Unlike surgery, where I cannot tell where the cancer starts and where it ends, and that's why sometimes our re-excision rates are so high, we have to go back and re-excise a second time or even a third time to obtain clear margins for breast cancers. Ablation is done under direct visualization, under ultrasound, so I can see exactly where the cancer is in the breast and apply treatment directly to the heart of the cancer. The procedure is also associated with less bleeding, infection, shorter recovery time, minimal scarring, and better cosmesis. Disadvantages include thermal injury, incomplete ablation, residual tumor, inability to assess the margins, as well as the tumor recurrence is currently unknown. Additionally, there may be an advantage to ablation. It induces immunogenicity or an immune response in your body that attacks the cancer cells. This is how it works. When heat or cold is applied directly to the tumor cells die, and they release tumor antigens or proteins, which are then drained by the lymphatics into the lymph nodes and taken up by the dendritic cells. These dendritic cells then stimulate your own immune system's T cells, which then come and mount an attack onto the cancer cells. However, this immune response generated by the ablation alone is not enough to expunge the tumor entirely. That is why there is currently very exciting research going on looking at combining ablation and immunotherapy, such as ipilimumab, to treat breast cancer. We at Columbia offer three types of thermal ablation to treat women with breast tumors, both benign and malignant. The first is interstitial laser therapy, where we use laser energy or electromagnetic heat to slowly heat the tumor and kill the tumor cells. This was approved by the FDA in 2007 for the treatment of benign tumors up to 2 cm. This is how it works. The tumor in the breast is localized by using the ultrasound. We then place a probe directly into the tumor under visualization. A second probe, which measures temperature, is placed alongside the tumor. Laser is activated in the middle of the mass, and it destroys the tumor from inside out. Afterwards, the probes are withdrawn. And a Band-Aid is placed on the breast. And the patient walks home out of the clinic. So we just finished a multi-center trial where we used laser to treat breast cancer. This was followed by an excision. We still performed the lumpectomy afterwards for pathologic correlation. And this is what we found. So we treated 10 patients here at Columbia. The average tumor size was 11.7 millimeters. It ranged from 4 to 19 millimeters. 6 out of 10 patients had invasive duct carcinoma. And 8 out of 10 were grade 2, intermediate grade tumors. And 6 out of 10 were luminal cancers, where they were either estrogen receptor positive and or progesterone receptor positive and HER2 negative. We did treat one patient with focal ductal carcinoma in situ. Maybe that patient did not need treatment after all, after I heard Kathy's talk. So these are our results. We treated 10 patients. The tumors, out of the 10 patients, 3 patients could not be treated per protocol. 2 of them, the temperature would not reach the desired threshold of at least 60 degrees instantaneously or 50 degrees for about 2 minutes. The other patient, it was difficult to localize because she developed a hematoma when I repeated the biopsy, and it was harder to find the lesion after that. So out of the 7 patients, remaining 7 patients that were treated by protocol, 6 out of 7, 86% of these patients had complete tumor ablation. The tumor was killed completely in those patients. The other patient who did not had a larger tumor that was larger than 15 millimeters. So if we look at the subset of patients whose tumors were smaller than 15 millimeters, those were 6 patients whom we treated. 6 out of 6, or 100% of those patients had complete tumor ablation, tumor destruction. And this is what it looks like. On the left image, sometimes with lumpectomy surgery, the patients end up with a scar, not only externally, but internally, and they may end up with a deformity. And it is very hard for us to repair that. There's a cavity. We remove, excise the tissue. It's very difficult to replace that tissue. It's gone. Now, this is the patient on the right whom we treated with laser. Can you tell where she had the treatment? Her scar is actually here. She had 2 needle scars. It's in the right breast at around 8 o'clock. She healed up very well. You can't even tell where her scar is. And there's complete preservation of the form and shape of that breast. She was very happy with her result. Cryoablation uses cold to treat breast tumors. And this is the second type of modality of thermal ablation that we offer at Columbia. And the way it's performed is similar to the laser ablation. The tumor is localized under ultrasound. We see where it is. We place a probe directly into the tumor, and we activate the cold or the freezing cycle. It forms icicles inside the tumor cells. And then this is followed by a thaw period where the water content in the cells expand, breaking or lysing the cells. Followed by a third phase of freezing, which is offers a second kill to these cancer cells. And we are part of a multi-center trial that uses cryotherapy to treat breast cancer without surgery. So these are patients with very small cancers, up to 1.5 cm luminal cancers, who are age 60 and older, who were treated with cryotherapy alone, without surgery. So far, these are the interim results. 123 patients have been enrolled, 3 failed screening, so 120 of them were treated. Among the 120 patients who were treated, it was performed successfully, the procedure, in 100% of the patients. And so far, up to 2 years of follow-up, there was one patient who developed local recurrence. That's 0.8%, comparable or even better than surgery. The study is ongoing. And this is one of the patients who was treated here at Columbia. Again, can you tell where she had her treatment? She actually had it in her left breast at about 4 o'clock. And if you look over here on this view, again, you cannot even see her scar. And the shape of her breast is completely preserved. And she is very happy with her result. Okay, the third treatment, the third modality we do is high-intensity focused ultrasound, and we're currently using it to treat benign breast tumors called fibroadenomas. Would you be able to play the tape? There is a video embedded. Oh. Thank you. This is how it works. This is truly non-invasive. A probe is placed onto the breast to localize against the tumor. And the high-intensity focused ultrasound waves, beams, are then generated. And they focus onto the tumor. It can generate the heat up to 85 degrees Celsius. It is very precise. It moves around, the focal point moves around the tumor until the tumor is completely destroyed. Okay. And again, afterwards, the patient walks out of the clinic and goes home. So we are participating again in the multi-center trial using high-intensity focused ultrasound to treat benign breast tumors, and this is open for enrollment. There are currently 3 trials using thermal ablation to treat breast tumors here at Columbia. First is the laser ablation for fibroadenoma, second cryoablation for breast cancers, and the third is high-intensity focused ultrasound treatment for fibroadenoma. And if you or your friend would like to participate, this is our number. I have to put in this plug. Please call us at 212-305-9676 or visit us on our website at columbiasurgery.org. We look forward to working with you and caring for you. So in conclusion, thermal ablations appear to be promising and safe methods for the treatment of breast tumors, and they offer the possibility of treating breast tumors without surgery. However, more research are needed to assess these new techniques. Thank you.